For decades, punk music in its most extreme forms has been a beacon of counterculture and progressive values, combating the very nature of what is deemed the norm, and rising up in pure defiance of what was deemed traditional. Throughout time, hardcore punk has serviced the pariahs, weaponized to exhibit the most brutal truths of the world we live in, complete with the tantalizing notion that change could be possible. From Ian McKay to Jamie Josta to Henry Rollins, Billy Joe Armstrong to Gerard Way, punk and its many children have attracted many of the largest figures in counterculture music, sort of like this cult of personality, providing a platform to discuss issues of a large-scale value that were oftentimes ignored by the greater musical landscape and mainstream, but further express themselves through a musical style that vented those frustrations and enraged tendencies in their entirety. But I am not here today to talk about the Misfits or Minor Threat, Black Flag, or Green Day. I am here to discuss a band that quietly carved out a corner of the underground, burrowed their way up through the dirt below, and have since become a sensational, polarizing, hated, and beloved band all at once. A brother and sister's creation, a namesake originating from an anime of all things, full to the brim of politics, angst, mental health, and fronted by a proudly out and vocal trans woman, boasting an idiosyncratic micro niche to boot. Today, I'm going to be shining a spotlight on the band SeeYouSpaceCowboy. With a relatively normal beginning, siblings Connie and Ethan Sgarbossa had participated in a variety of local underground projects that are pretty much unknown before coming together as the band that we know today. And they sort of ping-pong through different labels in hopes of finding a home, releasing EPs and demos that rarely gained massive attention. And it was not until 2019's Songs for the Firing Squad released that this project catapulted into the mainstream eye. Many online sources took notice of this record, with its rollout on the popular label Pure Noise, sitting shoulder to shoulder with bands such as The Amity Affliction, Can't Swim, Knocked Loose, and Hawthorne Heights, amongst many others. And this would give you a solid impression of their vibe. You see, this track listing was a compilation of prior outings. Put together on a large-scale label, it finally reached the audience that would allow SeeYouSpaceCowboy to truly meet their potential and reach a larger audience. And this was further exemplified and finalized, I would say, by the coverage given to the band by the incredibly influential and popular music reviewer Anthony Fantano, very positively, I should add. His coverage of this project caused an uproar within the underground, as the subsection of his fan base that enjoy extreme music and metal music are carnivorous, ravenous to devour the slightest recommendation of a metallic record of any sort. So SeeYouSpaceCowboy's increased popularity gave way to many comparisons to other genres and projects, namely the screamo genre, which the band has disavowed on numerous occasions, preferring to stray away from that label designation. But the genre that has been re-energized largely by this band would be the niche subgenre known as Sasscore. Defining the genre is very difficult, I'll admit, as it's heavily debated what determines a project's validity, but generally speaking, the construction consists of high-tempo, mathcore-esque riffs, not too unlike a Dillinger escape plan, with a flamboyant vocalist performing what can only be compared to whimpers and screeches, and distorted guitar work reminiscent of the screamo-influenced grindcore of the 2000s. And while Songs for the Firing Squad properly embodied that, with their 2019 debut studio length album in the same year, the correlation between entrance and exit wounds, SeeYouSpaceCowboy and namely Connie managed to stake their claim on the genre as the oddities and anomalies that they were, touching on so many topics that resonated with so many people. Because past the distortion and the time signatures that warped and twisted themselves together, their diverse sound read like a horrific amalgamation of mosh-friendly metalcore breakdowns, raging post-hardcore and hardcore punk riffs, and vocals that would display a range that I can only describe as staccato, with a roller coaster bounce to them, wherein Connie engages in guttural, raspy growls, catapults herself into high-pitched shrieks and wails, then immediately slides into whimpering croons. Cloaked in this brutalized and downright strange aesthetic that reeks of the 2000s but somehow feels futuristic all at once, SeeYouSpaceCowboy's growing popularity showcases a knack for music listeners, especially heavier music listeners, to clamor for the unique, for the out there, for the odd, and they certainly fit their criteria, but so much more is at play here. You see, Sea Space Cowboy has been the subject to a wide amount of support, yes, but also a grand amount of polarization and hate. This can come down to many things, but mostly two major things: mental health depictions and LGBTQ plus representation. On one hand, SeeYouSpace Cowboy packs in what many would call edgy angst, not too unlike some of the more grim emo and screamo bands of the 2000s. They face many of these same topics with eloquence and grace, but also a bluntness and a disregard for what might be shocking or particularly appalling. It's this raw, unfiltered way of crisply busting through and allowing for such detached emotions to come to the forefront in a blistering realness that people appreciate. And then we have the other sort of representation. In recent memory, SeeYouSpace Cowboy, with the track The End to a Brief Moment of Lasting Intimacy, many queer individuals can be seen in provocative and intimately sexual and sensual acts amidst the lyricism itself, including Connie. In the current age, trans women are held to a variety of standards due to extended negative media coverage. Just look at liturgy. And furthermore, the stigmatisms that all queer people face really do play a role as well, but namely when you are a trans woman in any sort of metal sphere or rock sphere or punk sphere, you are going to be fighting so many things to even be recognized as a person, as a human. So to have a band that already garners so much polarization and hatred for their frontwoman and their lyrical topics face these things so head on, it's not only incredible to see, but very impressive to see the acclaim that they continue to receive in the public eye, especially when you take into account all of the hatred and all of the transphobia that Connie has had to deal with throughout SeeYouSpace Cowboy's very short runtime. And they only continue to prove what they provide on the record. Said track is from The Romance of Affliction, with an album cover that reminds me kind of Circle Takes the Square, and an even more intense and harsh outlook, complete with the riffs becoming more crazed, and the disassociation and pure mania SeeYouSpace Cowboy portrays in their music is quite literally unparalleled in modern memory, because even with bands like Vane on the block performing these hyper mathcore ragers, even they do not scratch nearly the same itch. And I think a lot of that comes down to the thematics, because the bravery and courage of Connie to continue to not only proudly be herself without fear, but go into interviews with her head held high in a genre that very much can be perceived as dangerous to all queer people, let alone trans women, all while packing these raw and despondent emotions and other sorts of representation into the music, is a case that deserves to be studied and watched. Because SeeYouSpace Cowboy show no signs of stopping. Their unique combination of genres and the revitalization of the past and bringing together so many sounds that so many people look back on so fondly, all while breathing life into these fresh corners of the dim alleyways that their music dwells in, makes them fascinating to behold, incredible to listen to, and wonderful to talk about. And as for them not stopping anytime soon, I sure hope they don't, because I truly feel like they have so much left in them still, and more surprises bound. And I can't wait to see what the future entails for this project and for Connie.